stories from the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The picture for today, Halima Sa'diya returned the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he was 5 years of age to his mother, Amina. And that year was the last year in the life of Amina. They planned a trip to Al-Madinah, where she took Muhammad, the child, at age 5, to visit the grave of his father, Abdullah, who was buried in the Medina. It was probably a good time he spent there in that vacation, which lasted a month. There, he tells us, he visited the grave of his father, and later on, he reminisced and told his companion that this is the tomb of my dad, and he showed them the places where he used to play with the kids, and a hill where there was a bird apparently in captivity, and he let him go free, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed where he learned swimming in the swimming pool of Bani Najjar. He had good time, but good time usually passed very fast, and at the end of that month, they had to go back to Mecca with the caravan. And halfway through, in a village called Al-Abwa, his mother fell sick, and very quickly she deteriorated and she died. And she was buried there by the caravan. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, at age 6, cried, and who wouldn't cry for the loss of a mother? And he was now alone, lost both parents. And the only person who stood by him is Baraka, his servant or his babysitter. She hugged him dearly and tried her best to give him comfort. And very quickly, the caravan continued the trip, and she took him right away to his grandfather, Abdul Muttalib. Abdul Muttalib took care of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the age 6 till age 8. And he showered him with love and support. And Abdul Muttalib, being the chief, at least of the spiritual aspect of Quraysh, he would have a special mattress at the Kaaba, and the big guys of Quraysh, the chieftains, would sit around. And Muhammad, at age 6, he used to go and sit in the place of Abdul Muttalib. His uncles tried to remove him, but Abdul Muttalib tell him, leave my son here. He will have a very bright future. And you imagine Muhammad at age 6 sitting behind the back of Abdul Muttalib, looking at the big powers in Quraysh and see the greed and the interest of everyone playing politics and so on, and Abdul Muttalib trying to, as a ruler, to solve problems. So the Prophet had a vantage point of seeing how the powerful people work in these 2 years. Abdul Muttalib, always he would wipe the hair of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam at that age, and his back. And he would have very nice words to him. This has a lot of impact on an orphan. That's why Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, if you want to go to heaven, just wipe on the hair of an orphan. It has tremendous effect, assurance. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَوَجَدَكَ يَتِيمًا أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ يَتِيمًا فَآوَى, it's not only a shelter. It's not taking care physically of him. It is far more than that. It's taking care of him mentally and emotionally and his psyche. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in taking care of all of this with those wonderful people around him, And Abdul Muttalib was in his 80s, and he became very sick, and he died very soon. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam received another hit, and he cried him. As a matter of fact, Baraka says, I have seen Muhammad at age 8 behind the bed of Abdul Muttalib, sitting down crying very hard. Then Abu Talib came to the picture. Abu Talib was a brother of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, father from both sides, mother and father. And he loved Muhammad more than he loved his children. And he took care of him from the age 8 till he became at age 50. So it's a long time. Abu Talib had gave the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam big support from all aspects. He was the true father in his life. Also the wife of Abu Talib, her name is Fatima bint Asad. She was the best human being to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, إِنَّهَا كَانَتْ أَحْسَنُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ لِي صَنِيعًا. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was very shy, and he is very sensitive. Whenever they put the food to eat, and you know the children of Abu Talib, they were many, boys and girls, he would shy off to come and elbow his cousins to eat. So he would sit down alone on the side, and wouldn't touch the food. So Fatima bint Asad, radiallahu anha, she died Muslim. She would take his portion of food and put it aside to him. And Abu Talib would not let any of the kids to touch the food till Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam comes and eat first. He did that not only out of love, but he noticed whenever the kids eat and there was shortage, the food never been enough. And the kids would fight for the food. But whenever Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes, the food with the blessing of the Prophet would multiply and they eat all of them and they would be left over. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam been in a special position of love and comfort. We know these feelings we describe are very essential in our life. We need very bad, and this goes all the way to our genes. The feeling of appreciation, the feeling of acceptance, approval, and the affection and sympathy. Those when you provide to the child. And you know, all of us, we have angels and beasts inside our genes. We have them come always in alleles, in pairs. And who makes the difference, who push the buttons of the good or bad, is the environment. That's why they say we are context specific. If you are in a good company, good family, functional family, good parentings, the child would have those good genes or good spots been pushed, you find the person is good, and vice versa. So who you are, how you behave, is dependent on the environment around you. And this is a very important lesson for us, to take care of the kids, appreciate them, pamper them, give them good advice. Of course, if they deserve it, you don't spoil them. All of us, we know the story of the one who killed 99 people, and he asked if there's any way for him to be forgiven. And to make long story short, the alim, the scholar, he told him, yes, you repent and you start a fresh life, but with one condition: change your environment. Go from this village to that village. This is bad village, this is good village. So all of you know the story, it's in the Bukhari. He went and halfway through he died. And then the angels came and disputing them. The man killed 99. He's bad. Never did anything good. So they want to take him to hell. But the angels of mercy said, well, he repented. Allah accept anyone when he repents. So anyway, Jibreel came and he measured the distance between the two villages where he died. And he found it closer to the good village. So he went to heaven. May Allah forgive us. Inshallah, tomorrow we'll have some more stories from the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Assalamu alaikum.